And who wrote his book, God knows it. Similarly, there are other views. But simply want to try knowledge. I was speaking that evening in the light of the Quran. This problem of the civilization and development of the self, you may call it moral culture, you may call it mental hygiene, you may call it character building. This is a vital problem of human life or thinking. And a comprehensive philosophy of life that Islam is, it is that reason that it must have human guidance in their country. That guidance is there. And so it is only that which has been taught by masters like Oscar and Theodore Khalid al-Jilani or Sayyidina Sheikh Shahabuddin al-Qarawazi or Sayyidina Sheikh Ali Hudaybi or Sayyidina Khalid al-Jilani. I will say those who are classical masters, wisdom must be based on what they are. What so and so is doing and what so and so is doing and what so and so is doing. Muslims and Christians and Muslim life have become degenerated in various times. So any Muslim cannot be made a standard that so and so Muslim is speaking to suburb in that time. The common suburb that I have been pointing out is at the first level moral culture in the life of Islam. On the second level it is spiritual culture, and there it ends. The problem why one person should have a Muslim is only a teacher. She is not a good, she is not an Indian, she is not something fair. The Muslim is only a teacher if there is a person who is really qualified as a Muslim. Then even the Muslims also, that's when the Muslims who can teach only at the primary level, like other teachers. Again, the Muslims who can teach at the lower primary, the others at the higher primary, the others at lower secondary, other than higher secondary, and so on. But the word Muslim means only a person who guides in terms of knowledge of that moral culture and spiritual culture. The person who does not undertake it, we call it just Muallim, and because this man goes to the depth, the thing we call it Muslim. The badge which is given to God, the Muslim is Muslim of God, not of that Muslim. Muslim is from the word irada. Irada means to resolve. Resolve a effect or for the first time, even for the born Muslim, it may be, they become conscious that he should try to spend up his life according to Islam. And he should try to benefit from what Islam has said in connection with his fraternity culture and his spiritual problem. So when he makes this irada, then he becomes murid. Murid means only one who makes the irada. Irada in Islam is for God and God alone. Anna ila rabbika al-muntaha. Unto thy Lord is the goal. So anybody who makes this irada that I wish to traverse this path honestly, where I may attain this goal, where I may attain my God and my Creator, he is the Muslim. Muslim, none of that Muslim. He only gives the bath or the flesh, making that person as his teacher and consequently also as his witness. Their flesh. Because for every contract there is always a witness. So he is only a witness. And this gentleman accepts him as a teacher. Just as you may accept anybody as a teacher for teaching mathematics or Greek or geography or history or anything. Doesn't go here about money. Then the path is the path of the sunnah. Because Holy Prophet Muhammad gave perfect example, accurate. And the Quran contains the full technique of this. And the Hadith contains the technique. One question was asked in the letter which I have in my pocket here. Could you kindly give me a little detail? I want more sheep than flowers. Excuse me. Sir, my dear friend, would you mind me tranquil and quiet? I was thinking about this, that Islam has provided for it, but conditions change from person to person. Those who have learned the theory of education, even in connection with what is called worldly education, they know that every theory of education has to provide for variations in temperaments and other conditions of the youth. In connection with the spiritual makeup or the mental makeup of different individuals, there are numerous types of variations. And it is because of this that you find these different orders. Especially it was asked, why so many orders? And a person viewed that system of education according to his temperament and built it up, another according to his temperament. The mental makeup and the moral makeup and the spiritual makeup and the physical makeup of your two persons is right. But if you study seriously, you will find that every classical Sufi order has got exactly the same fundamental teaching. Just as the four schools of Sunni law, Hanafi and Shafi'i and Maliki and Hanbali, fundamentally they are the same. Differences are in only in the things which are secondary. So this thing could not make a person forsake Islam still, because there is not one school of thought, because the Tabi'is say Amin Bizar and the Hanafi don't, so this is transmitted. And they, that is not the way of thinking, it is very non-collaborative. If you ask me questions, you should ask the questions that God gives some thought to them, so those questions. Whatever I have been saying, try to understand it properly, then build up your questions. And if you have to take so much time that you can only write to me when I am in Karachi, when I have left your country,